That is an intelligent delivery, and Souchek is good in the air, and a cross has finally worked. No way, we've actually scored from this. I've been trying to score like this for so long, and we might be on a counter-attack with Benrahma. Here he goes. He's not the fastest player, but he's able to dribble on the ball really well, and he slotted that one home brilliantly. Last episode, we made the decision to sell our only fit striker in Antonio to Bilbao for about £16 million. And with Patrick Schick, our only other striker at the club right now, is out for the next 5 months with that cruciate ligament injury, and that means we're on the hunt for a striker in this January window. Good thing is, with the Antonio money, we've got the cash to make that happen, about £25 million. That's not enough to bring in a proper quality striker, so we're gonna have to be smart about it. And in today's episode, hence, it's gonna be a hunt to find a proper striker for West Ham and to try and take them to the next level, because we need to bring in a striker with the current situation we've got at our club. So it's going to be a bit of a challenge. We'll be firing through January. Also, Europa League knockouts begin in this episode, so a lot to look forward to. If you're enjoying all the transfer madness and all that sort of stuff of this West Ham career mode, consider dropping a like in the video. It really helps the channel grow. Subscribe if you're new around here as well, and well, let's get on with it. Today's video, guys, is sponsored by Onefootball. Just a couple of days away from the brand new Premier League season beginning, and guess what? Onefootball have got an amazing giveaway to celebrate just that. A chance to win a brand new copy of FIFA 22 when it comes out, a Onefootball kit, and also a jersey of your favorite football club. That's what you can win by entering this giveaway. And also, there's a bumper prize of a chance of winning a few Premier League match tickets as well. So what are you waiting for? Click the link in the description below. Download the Onefootball app, fill all the details in the form, and here's the fun stuff. You gotta predict the first five Premier League games of this season. I've already done mine, which you guys can see, a few controversial ones in Leeds winning and Spurs winning, but we'll see if I'm right. So yeah, make sure you, of course, download the Onefootball app. Links in the description for the giveaway. Big ups to them for sponsoring today's video. Let's get back to business. Press conference to kick off today's episode. You could do a swap deal for a striker with Schick if you don't get any offers for him. So as you guys know, since we are going to fail the objective with Patrick Schick, selling him is like our only option come next season. And this is actually a good idea, but the problem with this is we're not going to get good value for it. If you look at his value, he's worth about 40 million. And trust me, once he recovers from his injury, he's going to quickly go back to like an 84 rating soon. And if we sell him then, we could get upwards of 50 million for him. So I really feel instead of cashing out now, it's just smarter to wait until next season. Yep, it means we'll struggle to get a quality striker in this window. But long term, I think it will benefit us. So I'm not selling Schick just yet. But of course, I don't think we're using him anymore in this save unless he's somehow available in the final month of the season. We'll see though. He might make it by then and we'll have a good sending off for him. But it's a sad situation with Schick, but I'm just hoping we get to play with him at least a few times before we end off season 2. Next up, Bowen is performing amazing in the centre forward role, so maybe bring in someone for that winger spot instead of a striker. Interesting comment that, but I really feel like we're covered for the wingers departments. Jacob Andrews can play there, Benrahma, we've got Payet, Mason Mount, these players can play in those positions, and I'd rather trust them there rather than bring in a winger and try and take away time from Jacob Andrews, whereas we don't really have that out-and-out striker. And I think in some games, we will need that. Some games, Jared Bowen at centre-forward won't work, especially against teams that defend a lot. So that's why I still feel like bringing in a striker is necessary. Next up, improve Jacob Andrews' pace because he isn't that fast currently. You're right. Jacob Andrews has got a weird split on his pace stat. He's got 80 pace, but 76 sprint speed and 86 acceleration. That means he's great off the mark, but he slows down pretty quickly. So I think we're going to first try and convert him to a left winger to get those overall boosts on him. And then the play is to give him plans that boost that sprint speed up massively. That's how we're going to work with Jacob Andrews. But yeah, I have noticed this. And we're going to surely work on that sprint speed stat very soon. Okay, so Antonio is gone. We're on the hunt for a striker. And I actually have a couple of options that could really work well for us. Do we take a look? I think we do. One of them is Jamie Vardy. Now, I know he's not going to be a long-term signing, but that means we could get him for a fantastic deal because of his age. I know his wages are high, but one thing that made me convinced that this could be the man for the job, he's still got 86 sprint speed, 87 acceleration, 88 finishing. Some of his stats are still fantastic. And with that pace, I think he can be a great option off the bench or even as a starter. I think it's a very smart signing to make because with the money we've got, we're not signing any of the young talents in that striker position. They're just too expensive. So Vardy would be an amazing signing. Plus, it's something unique. Not many people make signings like this in their career modes. Danny Ings is another option, but he's slightly more expensive. That's the problem, yeah. We'll still scout him. We'll still give it a go. But right now, I'm feeling Jamie Vardy is the man for the job. But yeah, this would be a lot of fun to try and pull off. Vardy having a party at West Ham. Count me in. Also, a quick look at our season objectives. Good news, Jacob Andrews is going to be staying. We've completed the objective with him, so that's done. Of course, the Schick objective, we've basically failed it, so yeah, that's an L that we've taken. In other news though, Bowen is just 15 goal contributions away from completing his objective, so we're looking pretty solid completing the final one, so yeah, pretty happy with the progress. Okay, so I'm actually not going to be putting in offers for Jamie Vardy just yet, because I want to scout Danny Ings, because I think he'd be the more ideal transfer, plus I want to see what kind of rating he's on, so for now we'll just keep simming and see what's up, and yeah, we need to get to know more about Danny Ings before we make a move, but 100%, by the end of this window, I want a striker. Oh my, an offer coming in from Borussia Dortmund for Jared Bowen. They're offering me Thorgan Hazard, but get out of here. I don't want Thorgan Hazard. I know he's decent, but nah. Rejecting it, man. Come on, Dortmund. You knew I wasn't going to accept that. In other news, we get this one against Burnley out of the way with a 2-0 win. West Ham winning, Benrahma and Payet scoring for us. We'll take it. Honestly, guys, I know we're facing City in the FA Cup. I like the competition. We won it last season. But this season, I'd rather focus on the Prem and the Europa League. So we're just going to ride our luck and sim this and see what happens. Honestly, no way we're getting through with the team we've fielded here. They're playing Griezmann and all. Like, honestly, it's going to be... Yeah, it's going to be a bloodbath, and it was. 4-2 for City, but it's fine. The focus for me from now until the end of the season is sorting out transfers, that striker, and of course, winning the Premier League and maybe even the Europa League. Oh man, it's still saying 6 more days to like scout Danny Ings. We might just have to go in with an offer, guys. In other news, Vardy's price has gone down because his overall has dipped as well. So maybe we can get him for like a cheaper deal. So that works out in our favor. But the question is, is it possible to sneak a signing in for Danny Ings? Because if it is, I'd rather have this because I know he's younger. He'll be better. He'll be very effective for the job we need him to do. The problem is we don't have much leeway in terms of negotiations. We do not have the cash in hand to pull off a transfer like this. Yeah, this is out of question. If you're going to ask 39 million for Danny Ings, I'm sorry, man. I just don't have the money to make that happen. I can counter with 26, but that's about it, really. Yeah, Danny Ings is out of question. It's going to have to be a player like Jamie Vardy. I told you guys, with the money we've got, I'm maybe going to try out for an older player because that's what makes sense. We still want to use Bowen in the big games in that centre-forward role. I just want someone to be there in case we want to revert to a classic number 9. All right, guys, now we try with Jamie Vardy to see if this is possible. The good news is he should be a bit cheaper. I'm going to start off directly with a low-ball offer of like 16 million just to see if that's going to work. They want Tanganga. No way am I giving y'all Tanganga. Come on. We'll counter with, let's say, 18 million then. 18 million for Jamie Vardy. Flat fee. Let's see if we can pull it off. They're willing to work with 18.5. Okay, I don't mind that. We get a striker who's got a bit of pace. Way more than actually even Schick and all. And Antonio might be good for the rest of the season. Long term, of course not. I get that. But right now, I can only see a short term benefit. And that's exactly what I want. We are kind of spending a bit more money than what we got for Antonio, so that's a bit of an L right there, but I don't know, man, I've got a feeling Jamie Vardy for us is going to be special, even if it's just for 6 months. He's won the Premier League before, he's got the experience. Hopefully, this is a signing that's actually benefiting us, because, yeah, some of the older signings we normally make, they never work out, so hopefully this time, things will be different. Plus, let's be real, guys, Jamie Vardy in this series... It's going to be special because I remember using him in the Leicester career modes and it was always a lot of fun. And again, I'm excited to do that here in, of course, this West Ham series. So let's hopefully pull it off. We still have negotiations to do. I'm going to counter with 80,000 or just offer him that. We'll give him like 250 as the signing bonus because let's be real. He's coming to West Ham. We can't offer insane wages, and I'm okay with this. So there you go. That's the offer done. And I'm sure by the end of the season, we'll have enough money to even complete the Curtis Jones offer. So perfectly fine for me. With that, we've just signed a striker in Jamie Vardy. Let me know in the comment section, guys. Is this going to be worth it? We'll let him have number 10 for now. He's a striker that has got a vast amount of experience in the Prem, but age is against him. But hey, sometimes age is just a number. We'll see. With that, guys, I'm actually done with our transfer business stuff in January. I think we're just going to smash through deadline day now. No more business, no more player sales as well. I'm happy with what we've got. In a way, I'm glad we're not in the FA Cup anymore. We don't have the squad to compete in three competitions. Two itself is going to be difficult. So there's that. Now it's just going to be straight up getting into all those big games. Another Premier League game out of the way, and it's a clean sheet as well. Junior Firpo and Benrahma scoring. We'll take that. Wait a second. What on earth has just happened in the Premier League? We're leading by 6 points? That is honestly mental. 6 points right now. What? That is insane. We're looking really solid to win the Premier League title this season. Let's just keep it going. Now, you guys will have to wait a bit to see Jamie Vardy in action. He is on the bench for this one. We're sticking with the false nine because it's been so effective. Bowen, another great game from him, hopefully. And in the second half, we're going to bring on Jamie Vardy for his, well, official debut, I guess. So let's do this, man. It's time to play Leicester. I'm definitely keen on seeing Jamie Vardy in action at some point in this game because it is his former club, Leicester, he's playing at. Of course, he moved to Real Madrid in this save briefly, so there's that. But still, man, Vardy against Leicester is going to be a bit emotional for what he's done for that club, helping them win the impossible, the Premier League, of course. So second half, can't wait for it. But hopefully we can score a few goals in this first half with Jared Bowen in that centre forward role. He's already on a bit of a run. Gets past one, goes for goal. At this kind of form, you just cannot stop Jared Bowen. Everything he touches turns into gold. He is literally unstoppable right now. This centre forward role, Bowen has made his own. Like, honestly, that's kind of one of the reasons why I didn't really want a first choice striker, because right now, the way Bowen is playing in the centre forward role, you'd be stupid to remove him and put him out wide because it is just working so well for him. 15 now in the Prem for Bowen. He's just not in the mood of stopping. He could end up winning the Premier League Golden Boot at this rate. Oh, what a pass that is for Jacob Andrews as he brings this one inside. Still goes. Chance to actually go for goal from distance. It's a good save from Schmeichel. And they managed to get it away. Now looks for Declan Rice. Strikes it. Oh, that's another good save from Kasper Schmeichel. We're coming at Leicester with everything we've got. Bonner. Benrahma to put this in. What's happening here? We get it back though. Benrahma again. Lobs this one in. It could be another goal. How has Evans blocked that? I'm sure he had no idea about it. We need a replay on this. Sushek with an incredible leap. Johnny Evans had no idea what was happening there. Oh my god, that should have been 2-0 West Ham. Oh, that's another good ball into the box. I wasn't even... It's Bowen with the header. I wasn't even commentating. I just whipped in a ball. And out of all the players in the box, it's Jared Bowen who ends up scoring from a corner. Probably the first one in years, I feel. I've actually scored from a corner, guys. And it's one of the smallest players on the pitch in Jared Bowen. You can't keep this man from scoring right now. He is doing everything. That's another one. 16? Yeah, 16 in the Premier League for Jared Bowen. Somebody just stop this guy because it's looking impossible right now. He is just on a completely different level. Oh, look at Bowen just sidestep everyone. He is just too quick right now to handle. Jared Bowen, tricky angle. Keeper makes a good save. I was trying to go across goal. Didn't have the power to pull it off though. You guys think it's time? Because I certainly do. It is time to see Jamie Vardy in action. What we're going to do, guys, is bring off Benrahma and do this. Should be fine. We'll use Jamie Vardy here. I think he should still do a great job. And let's do this. Let's put stay forward on Bowen as well. And yeah, Jamie Vardy's West Ham debut. Let's hopefully get him a few goals. And it's against this former team as well. Jared Bowen. If he could slide this one for Jamie Vardy. Here he is on the attack. You're opening up that extra bit of space. Trying to curl it home against a player he knows so well in Kasper Schmeichel. Good save. But if we can see stuff like that from Vardy, I think Yeah, we're going to have a good time with him. Oh, Jamie Vardy has opened up a bit of space here. Releasing this one, I tried to at least put the elements with the interception, but so far I'm seeing a lot from Vardy, which is what we want. We want him to be an amazing super sub option. Oh, could we see them making a comeback in this game? Diop with a very risky challenge. He had to get a bit of the ball. Thankfully, he did. Is Mason Mount? Could slide this one through for Jamie Vardy. Now we know he's got pace. Does he have enough, though? Oh, couldn't get past Romagnoli. We still have it, though, with Declan. Now Mason Mount sees Vardy, who tries to feed him again, but we still have it. Ah, Declan couldn't find Vardy again. Oh my god, that's a penalty. That is 100% a penalty. I messed up right there. I really did. It was a very harsh challenge. A bad challenge, I think is the better word. It wasn't harsh at all. It was a clear-cut penalty. Take a look at this, guys. I don't know why I did this. I literally took him out inside the box. And Leicester have a chance to get back in the game, but if Areola can save it, would have been nice, but Belotti went with the cheeky chip and put it in. So, yep, Leicester are back in it. Oh, Vardy has managed to turn his man. Still Jamie Vardy's on a great run, but he couldn't get past the third defender. He still got it, boys. He still got that pace where he can beat a couple of defenders, which is great to see. Might have to take out James Justin here. Oh, that's a very good delivery. That is a very risky interception from Diop. Oh, my God. He was playing with fire right there. We somehow played out from the back incredibly well, but my God, was that stressful. And there you have it, guys. Full time. We walk away with all 3 points. It wasn't easy, though. We really had to hang on towards the end. Vardy made his debut, but couldn't see much from him. Hopefully, in the next few games, we will. Okay, so round of 32 of the Europa League. We've drawn Olympiakos. Interesting. Some of the other teams in here. Ajax, Roma, Dortmund, Wolves in here, Atalanta, Nice. Some Chelsea, Inter, Villarreal, Atletico. Okay, now we're going to take our chances by simming the first leg. If it's a bad result, we'll play the second leg. If not, we'll start playing from the round of 16. That's the plan. First leg in the Europa League, round of 32. Olympiakos away as well against the Greek nation. A 2-1 win. Two away goals, Vardy scoring a brace, we'll absolutely take it. Liverpool are closing the gap, but of course we've got a game in hand. We just got to keep maintaining this kind of unreal form that we've been in. We now play City, who are a very difficult team to play. We're going to play this in this episode. We win this, and I genuinely feel it's going to be our league title to lose. So let's make it happen. You know what, guys? For this game, I'm going to ditch the false nine. I know it's super effective, but I want to use Jamie Vardy, man. Come on. Plus, against a team like City, to get in behind those defenses with the high line they play, Vardy might be the play. So I might also do this. I might have Jacob Andrews on the left as well. Yeah, that's, I think, the smart thing to do. Let's run this. West Ham versus City. Let's go. Against City, I feel like it's always been hit and miss for us. Like, sometimes we beat them and we play really well, but sometimes it gets really ugly. So I don't know what kind of a game I'm expecting here. We're trying out, of course, the normal formation with Jamie Vardy starting. Is that going to be a hindrance? I don't think so, as we almost got in behind there. But Chadwick Boone, with the form he's been in, it's kind of like a bit stupid, honestly, pushing him out wide. I know that, but I just want to use Jamie Vardy against the top teams and just see if he's still got that ability. Bernardo Silva looking for Mahrez. Back for Bernardo Silva, and he should get another pop at it. But Areola makes a very, very good save. Even game so far, 10 minutes in. Oh, that's a good ball. And Bernardo Silva almost scoring a screamer with his right foot out of nowhere. Pops up with that attempt. Fair enough, I guess. Fair enough. That wasn't too far out. Yo, we're not playing well, man. We're giving the ball away cheaply. Thankfully, though, our defenders have stepped up big time. And that's why we're actually doing fairly well. And now we might see a bit of Jamie Vardy in action. Looks for Souček. And now we've got options on this side. Jared Bowen out wide. Controls that really well. Gets past one. He is just unreal. Looks to play the ball back into the box. But Ruben Diaz with the block. Jared Bowen. Play him on the right. Play him on the left. Play him at camp. Play him at centre forward. Gets the job done. Bowen with a lofted ball in. And it missed everyone. Lisandro Martinez maybe could have done a bit better there. Okay, this long ball approach is annoying as hell. And Sterling, because of his pace, is going to get there. I might just try and take him out. And that's exactly what I've done. Funnily enough, it was a perfect challenge. And it's only a corner. Koufal absolutely clattered him. And well, Bowen with a bit of defensive work to win that from Sterling. And now we could hit the brakes. Let's go. Jared Bowen with a lot of pace. Breaking through this City defense. They've been caught out massively here. And it's a big chance for us to do something. Bowen chipping this in for Jamie Vardy. But he couldn't win the header. That was a chance and a half. We still have it though. It's Mason Mount. Difficult angle. Cut back for Souček. Come on. That should have been 1-0 against City. Golden opportunity wasted. Mason Mount. And now look at the spaces opening up. Jacob Andrews. Has he kept himself on? Jacob. Oh, come on. How are you going to get caught offside there? Need to hold back your run, my guy. Oh, Jamie Vardy. This is the pace I've been talking about. Jamie Vardy is having a party here at West Ham. Oh my God. This is why we paid 18 million for him. And there you go. He's flopping on the pitch. Unbelievable. Jamie Vardy has scored in a game against Man City. And this was just pure pace. Ran through that defense. Unreal from him. The finish was unreal as well, and we're leading 1-0 against City. We're destined to win the Premier League title this season, and with the extra firepower this man's bringing in, who's going to stop us now? Oh, we're sending Jamie Vardy now. He's gone through again. This is Jamie Vardy's night. Jamie Vardy, no, I was going to try and be unselfish then, laid off for Mount, but I didn't have the time. Should have done better. Really should have made a 2-0 there, but the West Ham faithful are going to be happy about this because that man, Jamie Vardy, has been on rail tonight. Mount looking for Vardy. Sees Jacob Andrews. Oh, that is a very intelligent pass for Declan Rice. I mean, we're playing some great football right here. Junior Firpo. Looks now for Mason Mount. Oh, couldn't get there, but we're outclassing Man City. That's the difference this team has made. The signings and all we've made, it's all clicking. It's all gelling. And we're looking like the best team in England. Immobile. Oh, that's a smart one from, I think, Lisandro Martinez. And now Mount. Ah, Jacob Andrews' movement sometimes can be a bit dodgy, but right now it's Mason Mount, all on his own, looking to maybe bring this one inside. Does so smartly, but Edison with a big save right there. City are just getting caught out again and again and again and again, and we've just been that good. But of course, keep in mind, the goal difference is just one. This game could go either way, and that's why we need to try and make it 2-0. Which we might do right now. Mount in a difficult position, and Mason Mount! Oh my God, what a strike that was. Some of the goals we're scoring this season, unbelievable. Mason Mount scores. If we win this game, we get back our 6-point advantage at the top of the Premier League. And it's looking very likely that's exactly what's going to happen. What a strike from Mount. The keeper didn't even move. It's 2-0 against Man City and we're cruising. Are City actually going to wake up now? It's Mahrez back for Rodri. Mahrez again. Good challenge from Diop. That was honestly nice. But why did I try a roulette with him? Now the pressure is again from Manchester City. But again, we work out well. And look at this pressure from them. They're throwing everybody at it. But Areola with a good save. Vardy, if I can find Mason Mount here. Does he have the strength? He does. Mason Mount holding off his man. Does superbly. Slots it home. This is utter humiliation for Manchester City. Mason Mount's having one of his best games. In a West Ham shirt, and for him to do that against City is unbelievable. What a performance from him. In fact, not even just him. Even Jamie Vardy is having a party out here. It is 3-0 against City and we keep marching towards the Premier League title. Kevin De Bruyne shooting and almost getting City a goal back towards the end of this game. But oh, did you see that from Koufal? That was a classy turn right there. And could actually end up starting a breakaway for us as I try and find Jared Bowen. Nah, that's maybe a bit too much. Oh, that's a good ball into the box. And well, City get a goal back at least. But it's just a consolation goal. With leading 3-1, it's all good, guys. It's all good. It's fine. And there you have it. That's it for the game. They just got that consolation goal. But that's about it. We're walking home with a 3-1 win that keeps us 6 points clear at the top of the Premier League. This does look beautiful, doesn't it? 6 points clear at the top of the Premier League. It really is our title to lose, and I'm not about to bottle this, guys. We've got the best goal difference in the league as well. We're front runners right now. We sim this one against Olympiacos, second leg, and well, we get through. So round of 16 of the Europa League, here we come. This has been the perfect episode. Player of the episode for me, Bowen or Mount? One of them, but I think Mount against City to score a brace. And that goal as well was just so good. Even Vardy deserves a shout. But I'm going to stick with Mount. In fact, let me know what you think in the comments. But for now, this is where we're wrapping up today's episode of the West Ham Career Mode. It was crazy. We managed to sign Jamie Vardy. for a good price. And guess what? He's already delivering for us. I know it's an unorthodox signing, but it's one that gives me a lot of fun in this game. So yeah, that's it. That's what, I don't even know what to say now. That's it for the video, I guess. We're going to be moving on and ending off this one. And for now, that's that for this one. I think it's been a great episode signing Jamie Vardy for that price. And guess what? He's already delivering for us. Next episode, we keep on that grind in the Prem, Europa League as well, because I think the serious business is about to begin there for us. So a lot to look forward to. If you're enjoying this series, you know what to do. Drop a like, subscribe, and I'll catch you all next time.